Article 11, motion reads, move that the town appropriate $50,000 to pay the cost of an owner's project manager and architectural services for the select board, including the payment of all costs incidental and related thereto, and to meet the appropriations, the treasurer with the approval of select board is authorized to borrow said amount under and pursuant to Chapter 44, Section 721 of the general laws, or pursuant to any other enabling authority, and to issue bonds or notes of the town therefore. Mr. Devine. Motion and a second? Motion and a second. Mr. Devine.
I'd actually like to ask the building committees to stand up and speak to this article for us, please.
David Tudrin, 346 River Drive, co-chair of the Municipal Billings Committee. First going to speak to the owner's project manager. The OPM is a consultant who acts as the town's agent and consultant, and consults throughout the project from design through construction, and is independent from the designer and the contractor. Pursuant to the state law, any municipal building's construction cost is, that's estimated to be $1.5 million or greater, an OPM is required. The library trustees already have hired a separate OPM, so that's not part of this warrant article. Some of the OPM duties would include advice in respect to the design, value engineering, identifying state and local permitting, cost estimating, scheduling, ensuring the work is tracking on time and on budget. Town projects that may include or require an OPM would be potentially a new senior center, a recreational center or a combination thereof, a future North Hadley Fire substation, or significant renovations to any of our buildings. The select board formed an OPM selection panel, which has made a recommendation to engage one of the specific respondents. And the proposed budget is an estimate for each, for the early phases of engaging an OPM. It does not reflect the entire value of the OPM contract necessarily, which will depend on the type and size of the proposed construction projects that we ultimately undertake as a town.
Thank you, sir. Any other questions?
Richard Truswell, Kennedy Drive, speaking as a town resident. Just a point of clarification. Did you say $50,000 or $350,000?
I said 50. They have lowered that amount, correct, Jerry?
That's the motion.
That's the motion.
Why is the amount lowered?
That's the motion for article, for the first part of that, Richard. It is 350 originally listed on here. And if you let us get through this first part, you'll understand as the second motion comes forward. That's the first motion for the OPM.
Yeah.
All right, Dan Dedkevitz, 130 Hockenham Road. Would this project manager be for every project you were just discussing?
That's correct, because each one of those projects would kick in at over $1.5 million, and that you need an OPM in order to do that. David?
Yeah, that's correct.
Shel Horowitz, 16 Barstow Lane, speaking in support of this. I'm very glad to see the town looking holistically at all the different projects that need attention instead of the piecemeal this, and this. I also speak as I served for 10 years or so on the Long Range Plan Implementation Committee. We met at Hooker. I was happy to be on that committee, but I was never happy to be in Hooker. I always came back with sore throat, tearing eyes. The library, of course, is too small. We need to do something about the North Hadley Town Hall. I'm really glad to see a systemic approach, and I hope we'll vote this in.
Sir?
Ken Jacobson, Bristol Lane. It looks to me like this is a done deal, looking at all the different approvals. But I'm just curious whether a real needs assessment has been done for either the senior center or the library. I'm hoping that we're not taking the position, if we build it, they'll come. Especially, and I'll just speak to the library for a second, especially with respect to the library, with changing and I think unknowable technological needs. I'm not sure what the library of the future is going to look like, and I wish we had taken the library up before the senior center, but I'm just wondering if we really know what the needs for a senior center are going to be, say, 10 years out. Have we done a real study?
Mr. Jacobson, if you could hold on to that question. As far as this motion is concerned, this sets up $50,000 for the OPM to be used in the future by the town of Hadley. We're not talking about individual buildings at this time or needs. That'll come later on tonight.
All right, I'm just making sure the camel's nose doesn't get under the tent before we get to discuss the merits of the projects.
Duly noted. Any other questions?
Yeah, I have a question.
Name and address.
John Michkowski, 4 Sunrise Drive. You want my age too?
No.
No? Okay.
I think you're old enough.
I can't understand for the life of me. I asked the selectman, I asked the building committee. I thought the charge was to set a priority. What is priority buildings? To check what we need for repairs, come up with a total. That project is not even done. Now everybody's jumping through the hoop, and I should think that I know they work very hard, but they're not done with their task. We can't afford things for departments to make our departments, give them raises, give them money to explore different things in their departments. But we can do all this stuff, but we can't take care of our house items. I can't understand this. When is the priorities of this town? What comes first and what comes not first? You know, that needs to be said. And the people of this town, they got to decide what they need. Not just we need to build things for luxury anymore, because there's no money around to do that.
Okay. It's coming up.
Hi, Dan Regish, Municipal Buildings Committee and the Senior Center Building Committee. This OPM is the horse. You have to put the horse before the cart. Molly indicated earlier that there was a 5-year plan. The building committee has been working at this for better than 2 years now. Now we're at the beginning of this 5-year plan, now that we've done all these studies. Yes, these studies have been done. We have lots of information from the senior center that shows there's a need. Regardless of the library's plans and what, you know, what becomes of that plan, there's a need for a senior center. There's a need for improvements to the public safety complex. There is a need for improvements to the DPW. There is a need for improvements. The building committee has gone over this time and time again. The Hooker School is an asbestos-filled, lead-lined, inaccessible, split-level, not-on-grade, unreinforced masonry building with obsolete heating, no air conditioning, overloaded electrical circuits, with really bad windows and insulation. We can build a new structure for much less than it would cost to fix this to a level where it would be marginally acceptable. It would still be a split level building, not very compatible with senior living. You know, there comes a time where you just have to call it quits with certain structures that are not compatible with modern living. There was a time when Hadley did this right, and 122 years ago when they built that Russell School, these modern building standards were not in effect, but that building still stands. That's how to do it right.
But I just, thank you, Danny, but I just want to caution everybody, the motion of this article is to borrow money to hire an OPM. This OPM is going to be involved in whatever we come up with for whatever building down the road. Let's not start discussing library, senior center, public safety. We'll be here until midnight and we won't get through this. I want to get let's start with, this is a position that is going to be needed in this town when we do decide to do anything with these buildings. What's that? It's going to be a contracted position, right? As used. Randy.
Randy Iser, 2 Autumn View Drive. Just so I and everybody else understands this, we're budgeting this money in case we need it. It's not being budgeted and automatically spent, correct?
Yeah, it's going to be, as we use it, we'll draw down from this $50,000. So if we don't do anything for a year and a half, that money just sits there until we actually do a project and we need this OPM.
Thank you.
Sir?
Yeah, Jonah Bruger, 21 Norwalk Drive. We've mentioned the 5-year plan a couple times. Could we just reiterate exactly how the OPM fits into the 5-year plan? And additionally, with the $50,000, exactly where are we borrowing that from?
Dave, you want to explain the $50,000 for the OPM again? Basically, any project, what's the number?
Over $1.5 million.
Any project that's over $1.5 million, you need an OPM.
Right.
And so that's why the building committee, the capital planning committee, the finance committee, the select board, that's why everybody's approving this position. They want to have this position and funds, more importantly than position, available so that when they do come with a recommendation to start fixing these buildings, this is in place and they won't have to come back for it. Is that correct, David?
That's right, Mr. Moderator.
Thank you. As far as, what was your second, the funding? Linda? He's asking about the funding for this,
Yeah, it says we're borrowing it. I just want to know where we're borrowing it from.
From the bank. No, Jerry. No.
Where do you go to rob money?
The cost. Go ahead, answer.
Specifically, where are you borrowing the money from?
It'll go out to bid. Short term note.
It'll go out to bid. Great. Thank you.
Yes, David.
This is a borrowing article. It's borrowing within the levy limit, so there'll be no impact upon taxes because it's going to be borrowed within Proposition 2.5. But of your taxes, we can tell you that of the taxes that you're going to, that the average single family household will pay within the Proposition 2.5, $3.80 per year for 5 years for this project, for this owner's project manager.
Thank you, David.
If supposedly there's nothing specific at this point to spend it on, why would we borrow?
You need to do it at a town meeting.
Cart, horse, ahead of the curve. That's what we're trying to do. We have to borrow this on town meeting. We see these projects coming down the road. We know these things are coming to us. We're trying to get this done now, so when we need to pull the trigger, it'll be available to us.
And this money stays specifically for this?
Specifically for it.
Okay.
Thank you. We'll be here till midnight.
Linda Sanderson, town treasurer, former finance committee member.
Yes. All right. This is authorization to borrow. It doesn't mean we're going to go out and borrow. In fact, we have some authorizations from last year that we haven't actually borrowed for yet because we haven't spent it. So when it's time to spend it, that and everything else that we spent during the fiscal year will be put out in a single note and borrowed. So our authorizations to borrow at any time are larger than our actual borrowing. So no, we will not be going and borrowing $50,000 until it is until it's clear that it needs to be spent.
Thank you.
Jane Nevin Smith, Sunrise Drive. I'd like to move the question.
Yeah. I assume by the applause, everybody is in favor of moving the question. Can you please signify with your gray card? Okay, thank you. All in favor, signify with your gray card. Opposed? One, two, three, four, five, six. Six opposed. Any abstentions? No. Article passes. It's two-thirds and more than passes. Motion number two within Article 11 is being passed over at this time. Questions? Brief ones? Thank you. Article 12, motion number one is being passed over. Motion number two. Correct? Move that the town transfer from water reserves $25,000 for an upgrade to the water division's SCAD system. Do I have a motion? Second. Mr. Devine will speak to this article. A motion. Excuse me. If you.
Marlo. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Marlo Warner, DPW Director. Let's give him a warm welcome at his first town meeting. All right, that's over. Get over to the mic. To the mic. Microphone. I'm sorry. Mr. Warner, the question's being asked of us, why a SCADA system, sir?
The SCADA system is a supervisory control and data acquisition, basically a computer system that runs our water filtration plant. It was online in 2007. Basically, the SCADA system has gone obsolete, no different than a home computer you've had for 7 to 10 years. It's an old 32-bit system. It needs to be upgraded to a 64-bit system. This system goes home, actually a laptop goes home with our operators at night. And this system talks to the computer so that if something goes wrong, they get an alarm, they can shut the plant down, they can adjust the plant right from home with this system. The upgrade of the system would allow also to go back a little further on data to research such as missing unaccounted for water and other things of data that interests us when we do our reports on the system.
Thank you. Seeing no further questions, all in favor of motion two, please signify with your gray card. Opposed? Abstentions? Motion number two passes unanimously. Motion three, move that the town transfer from capital stabilization the amount of $25,800 for the following capital expenses. IT upgrade, $6,300, that's for the public safety building. Vehicles from UMass surplus, $3,000, that's for the police department. Vehicle upgrades, $16,500. That's for the fire department, for a total of $25,800. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. Motion's been moved and seconded. Any questions? Hearing none, all in favor, please signify with your gray card. Opposed? Abstentions? Motion number three passes unanimously. Motion number four, move that the town appropriate $150,000 to pay costs of purchasing a backhoe and associated equipment for the Department of Public Works and for any payment of any other costs incidental and related thereto, that to meet the appropriation, transfer $25,000 from water reserves, transfer $25,000 from sewer reserves, and further that the treasurer, with the approval of the select board, is authorized to borrow $100,000 and issue bonds or notes, therefore, under Chapter 44, Section 7-9 of the General Laws, or pursuant to any other enabling authority, and to issue bonds or notes of the town, therefore. Provided, however, that the vote taken hereunder shall be expressly contingent upon approval by the voters to exclude the amounts to pay for the bonds and notes authorized for this purpose from the provisions of 2.5, so-called. Do I have a motion? Motion's been moved and seconded. Any questions? Mr. Michikowski.
Yeah, I would like to make a motion to take the $25,000 out of water reserve and $25,000 out of sewer reserve and put the total payment of $150,000 for that backhoe as it was 3.5 months ago. We voted for that, and at the election, it lost by 2 votes. I was one that voted no. And the reason I voted no, because there was no explanation at town meeting. I went to the town, I talked to Merrill, went there, looked at their report, and the mechanics gave me an envelope about an inch thick. I looked at his breakdown, it was like $34,000 to spend on this vehicle. I was a master mechanic for over 10 years, and the record keeping was the most important thing. In the business world, if the vehicle writes you out of, eats you out of house and home, it goes. But our water system and our sewer system, how's your water, folks? Is it great water? We get sand in the water, we got chlorine. A lot of the people got to drink a bottle of water. We need to keep this money in the reserve fund for water and sewer. I asked for the selectmen to put it for override vote, $2 million to address our infrastructure. Everything is kicked down the road. When we have a major collapse on Route 9 in sewer, your enterprise fund, your stabilization account of $2 million would be wiped completely right out, and that would put the town in grave danger. So I would encourage the people to take those two reserve numbers and go for the 150 on borrowing, on override vote. And I would pledge and encourage the people to vote for this piece of equipment because it is badly needed. It's eaten us out of house and home.
Mr. Michikowski, if I'm hearing you right, you're making a motion to amend this article?
Correct.
Could you please submit that in writing?
Got it.
Any other questions while Mr. Michikowski submits his motion? Hold on 1 second.
Is that sufficient?
At this time, I need a second to the amended motion. I have a second. Does anybody want to speak to it, to the amended motion? Amendment. Right, the amendment. You have a question about the amendment, Mr. Freeman?
No, not about the amendment, no.
Mr. Abel?
This isn't about the amendment.
Okay, well, we gotta talk about the amendment first, because then we gotta vote on it, and then we can stand up and talk about the rest of it.
Okay, this is about the amendment.
There we go.
Okay, I don't have the warrant in front of me because they ran out, so it's hard to follow, but if this is adding money to the budget, can we do that on the floor of town meeting, or am I misunderstanding the motion?
We're basically, Mr. Michikowski's amendment, under the original motion, they were taking $25,000 out of sewer reserves, they were taking $25,000 out of water reserves, and they were borrowing the $100,000. Mr. Michikowski wants to leave the $25,000 in the sewer reserves and the $25,000 in the water reserves, and he's basically eliminating those and saying you borrow $150,000 for the new backhoe. Is that correct, Mr. Michikowski?
Yeah, and the only reason they're really doing this because it failed the $150,000, and you're voting for the same thing, but watch your water fees, because when they drain this, and they're going to either double your fees, and they can do that, as sewer commissioners and water commissioners.
Mr. Moderator.
Nothing stopping them.
I would support the amendment for the reason that when the bond rating for the town is figured out, the bond rating agencies take a look at all the reserves. And when we reduce reserves, as we've done already so far tonight, it is putting our bond rating in jeopardy. And since we have a whole bunch of stuff that we might want to bond in the future, if there's any way for us to just put this, borrow it, the whole thing, and save the reserves, I'd be in favor of that.
I agree. Your reserves are basically your cash reserves, no matter if they're general stabilization, water, or sewer. When you're buying a piece of equipment of capital nature that has an expected life expectancy of probably 15 or 20 years, there's no sense paying cash for it when you can borrow it for next to nothing. And trust me, our interest rate that we borrow money on is fairly good and competitive. So I would say Mr. Michkowski's in the right track here. Any other questions? So we have an amendment to the motion, and it basically removes the $25,000 payment from the sewer and the water reserves. So it's basically we're going to borrow $150,000 for the new backhoe.
Right.
This is a vote to amend the motion. All in favor of amending the motion, signify with your gray card. Opposed? Abstain? 1, 2, 3. Abstentions? You can't abstain and oppose, sir. That's a nice try in the back. Thank you. The amendment passes. So now we go to the amended motion. And I'll ask, is there any questions? Yes, sir. Mr. Freeman.
Andy Morris, Freeman, 45 Roosevelt Street. Has anyone looked into the idea of leasing a backhoe when it's necessary, as opposed to purchasing a backhoe? A lot of towns are leasing heavy equipment like this. There's no maintenance costs, there's less insurance costs, and it just costs less in the long run.
Ken Parker.
Oh, hold on, Ken. Can I have the DPW director answer the question, please?
Yes, sir, I did. I looked into leasing and two or three different areas. Lease to own is about $23,908.50 a year, which would come to $167,000, which is obviously more than the $150,000. And when you lease, you're still responsible for repairs and maintenance. So in my estimation, lease to own, you're going to pay $20,000 plus on that machine as opposed to borrowing it outright.
How about as needed?
The as needed.
No, he's let the director speak.
I got it. One small example of leasing when you need it. Last Wednesday night when I was leaving the select board meeting, we had a water main break. We responded immediately with our own machine. To lease when we need it to turn the key at 2 a.m. or 10 p.m. To lease it and not have it on site or have it at the yard when we need it would make things very difficult. Then we would have to find a contractor with machinery and staff in the middle of the night to do our repairs, and that would affect everybody's getting their water back in a quicker fashion.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Ken Parker.
Ken Parker, 118 Mount Warner Road. That water break was right in front of my house. And I looked out and I saw these flashing yellow lights, and these gentlemen were out there. And this was one of those nights when it may have been getting down to freezing. And the water's gushing up and they're taking care of it. And they had to get the equipment up there. And when I went to bed at about 11 o'clock, they were starting to dig to get into this process. At 3:30 or 4 o'clock, they were gone. They'd done it, but they'd been out there in that freezing weather with the equipment that we had, and I think we ought to vote for this.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Mitch.
Again, I support this 100%. But I even looked further into this. Again, I was a master mechanic for 10 years. We have one mechanic taking care of the whole fleet of the town, police, fire, highway, schools. It's, I don't know how he can possibly do this. And there, in my opinion, should have 3 to 4 mechanics, oil change. None of these machines can't be serviced as factory spec because there's just not enough time and not enough personnel. We could extend lives, and we have done it to do
can
this. I would encourage the people to vote for this because they do need it.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. The question has been moved. Okay. The question has been moved, so I'll reread it for everyone. Move that the town appropriate $150,000 to pay for the cost of purchasing a backhoe and associated equipment for the Department of Public Works and for any payment of all other costs incidental and related thereto, that to meet this appropriation, the treasurer, with the approval of the select board, is authorized to borrow $150,000 and issue bonds or notes, therefore, under Chapter 44, Section 7-9 of the General Laws, or pursuant to any other enabling authority, to issue bonds or notes of the town, therefore, provided, however, that the vote taken hereunder shall be expressly contingent upon approval by the voters to exclude the amounts to pay for the bonds or notes authorized for this purpose from the provisions of Proposition 2.5, so called. It's been moved and seconded. All in favor, raise your gray card. Opposed? Abstentions? Passes unanimously. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. Thank you. 408-1. Have you got them?
There's one opposed. Yeah.
I declare that the 2/3 with threshold was surpassed in Article 12. On to Article 13. Passing over that, moving right along. Article 14, motion number 1. Move that the town appropriate $55,000 to pay the cost of replacing the roof at the public safety complex for the police department, including the payment of all costs incidental and related thereto, and that to meet this appropriation, the treasurer, with the approval of the select board, is authorized to borrow said amount under and pursuant to Chapter 44, Section 7-3A of the General Laws, or pursuant to any other enabling authority, and to issue bonds or notes of the town, therefore, provided, however, that the vote taken hereunder shall be expressly contingent upon the approval by the voters to exclude the amount to pay for the bonds or notes authorized for this purpose from the provisions of Proposition 2.5, so called.
What?
Motion's been moved and seconded, and just for everybody's information, Capital Planning Committee, it says recommendation pending, Select Board recommendation pending, Finance Committee recommendation pending. So do we have any questions?
Dave Ball? Well, do you have the votes?
Okay, so I've been told that the Capital Planning Committee, the Select Board, and the Finance Committee are recommending this motion unanimously. Okay, any questions? Hearing none, all in favor, signify with your gray card. Opposed? Abstentions. One abstention. Motion passes. Motion number two is passed over. So we move on to Article 15. Article 15, the motion reads, move that the town appropriate $550,000 to pay the costs of purchasing land in North Hadley for general government purposes, including the payment of all costs incidental and related thereto, and that to meet this appropriation, the treasurer, with the approval of the select board, is authorized to borrow said amount under and pursuant to Chapter 44, Section 3A of the General Laws, or pursuant to any other enabling authority, or to issue bonds or notes of the town therefore. Provided, however, that the vote taken hereunder shall be expressly contingent upon the approval by the voters to exclude the amount to pay for the bonds or notes authorized for this purpose from the provisions of Proposition 2.5. Do I have a motion? And a second? Been moved and seconded. Article 15 is Chairwoman Keegan. Would you like to speak to this? This is a two-thirds vote.
I think we're actually going to ask for the Municipal Building Committee to speak to this. But before Mr. Tudrin speaks, just to let you know the impact of $550,000 on taxes for an average single-family household. Valued at $311,800 would be $14.54 a year for 20 years. Mr. Tudor?
Thank you, David Tudrin, Municipal Buildings Committee. This spring, the Select Board, on the recommendation of the Municipal Buildings Committee, issued a request for proposals for available land to be used for town purposes. The town received two responses, one in Town Center, which would have been addressed under Article 11, and another one in North Hadley. Article 15 addresses a parcel in North Hadley. Initially, the Municipal Building Committee addressed the need for land in North Hadley to replace the fire services that currently reside in North Hadley Village Hall, the sale of which was approved in fall of 2014. Although the parcel which responded to the RFP far exceeds the space needs of a fire station, which we estimated to be less than 3 acres, the land not used for a structure, particularly on this parcel, could be used for other town structures for recreational purposes or other purposes, or that parcel or a portion of that parcel could be sold again. Our initial planning exercise indicated that the town could construct soccer fields and a softball field and potentially still have enough for the fire station, although that has not gone past a planning phase at this point, and Park and Rec has been consulted but has not voted on that. The town has not received approval from CPA to fund any of the purchase of the parcel for recreational purposes either. So this one is a little tough. We have approved the sale, but we've not formally entered into any agreements with any potential owners of the North Hadley Village Hall, so the fire services still reside in North Hadley Village Hall at this time. So a portion of this could be for town purpose or for the fire station or other purposes.
Thank you. Just to update everyone, in your warrant, I believe under Capital Planning Committee, it says recommendation pending. That has been updated. Capital Planning is against this article, 3-0. The Select Board recommends it 4-1, and the Finance Committee recommends it 5-0. Just against? Against. Finance Committee is against 5-0, just to update that.
Yeah.
Sure. You're a resident and a select board member. You most certainly can speak to that.
This isn't reflected of the selectman's recommendation. I asked to revote this article, and I would have voted no. They said we have pending policies, and we're not going to allow you to revote. My second request would be to ask the chairman of the Finance Committee to please come up to the mic and explain why his committee is voting 5-0 against, please.
Where is it?
Very simply, we can't afford it. I mean, our budget is as thin as it is. That's why we push so many things off to the fall. We don't have any extra money. We consider this as excessive borrowing. And we don't have an immediate purpose, urgent purpose for it.
Thank you, Mark. Any questions? Paulette.
Paulette Kosteba, Knightley Road. Question on this. I'm also a member of the CPA. And this property did come before the CPA. CPA said that they would most likely vote in favor of it. It needed to have additional information before it could. If part of this property is used for recreation, 100% of that cost could be covered by the CPA funds, which would have absolutely no impact on the tax base. Also, I am questioning the price of this because in looking at online, this property today or yesterday was listed at $499,000. So why would we pay more than what the list price is for the property?
Thank you for that information. You want to speak to that?
I think as previously mentioned, there's been a little bit of fluidity, for lack of a better way to put it, around some of these land articles. So just within the past few days, the bids were opened. This particular property responded to an RFP for us seeking land proximate to the town center. And even though this particular parcel exceeded the within a 3-mile radius requirement, the offer price in the proposal was $499,000, matching the figure that Paulette just stated. And the other thing I just wanted to explain, too, is when this vote was taken by the select board, it was taken a while back. We didn't have the benefit of the RFP information. Again, there was an awful lot of conversation continuing to go about what to do with North Hadley, the needs of the fire station, et cetera. And the select board at that time actually voted 4-1 with the four votes really indicating that they didn't want to kill the article at that time. They wanted it to continue to move forward to town meeting to engender discussion, which seems like it's doing tonight. So just explaining the position of the select board in that 4-1 vote that was taken at that time. The other thing I would just like to point out, just as a matter of, I think something else that should be taken into account in considering this article is, several of you probably remember that not that long ago, town meeting voted to purchase 7 acres of land behind Hopkins Academy, and that too will likely be coming in front of CPA at some point as well. So in addition to the land we already have at Hopkins, town owns another 7 acres for presumably additional field use. And again, I would just encourage people to take that into account in considering this article tonight.
Thank you. Mr. Dukiewicz.
Dan Dukiewicz, 130 Hockenham Road. I've got a question for the Finance Committee. Are you just opposed in regard to this particular piece of property, or are you opposed in buying any property for this public safety?
For public safety? No. I mean, we're opposed to buying this property because there doesn't appear to be an urgent need, and we consider that excessive borrowing. We're tight enough as it is. I mean, there's not a lot of extra money. You'll see that the last item on the town budget was debt and interest. We don't want to see that number get any bigger than it is.
Mr. Michkowski.
John Michkowski, 4 Sunrise Drive. There's a couple other points to this. That land is currently under 61A. The town has first refusals on it. They have 120 days to move on this. So there's no big rush to do that. What someone advertises is one thing. They can ask for $800,000. That land, whoever come up with this figure, that land was not appraised by a certified Massachusetts appraiser. And I don't know where all these numbers come from, whether somebody's an appraiser in-house here that we have that's putting them together, but I certainly would like to know. And in further research, I went to the surveyor that surveyed the property, and I asked him, I says, what is the maximum building we could put in there? And the building that we could come up with is 50 feet by 150 on that same site of North Hadley Hall. That would turn around, give access to the pond, possibly parking for the first the church next door, and a fire station and other uses on that land. And I think it's really jumping the gun again without looking at all alternatives. And I strongly would urge the people of this town and the voters and the taxpayers to vote no on this article.
Can I ask you a question about what you just said, because I wasn't clear? The 50 by 150, is that...
Mr. Horowitz, could you please go to the microphone so that everybody can hear?
I'm asking Mr. Miskowski to clarify if he's talking about the 50 by 150 where the existing town fire, sorry, existing North Hadley Town Hall is, or the property that is being considered for purchase.
That 150 by 50 is on the ball field of North Hadley Hall.
Yeah, but that doesn't address this.
And there's also about that land right there is, that land is all sand. That's across Stockbridge Road, that site. It would take probably hundreds of thousands of dollars of hauling clay in there and loam in there to satisfy. And there's another factor. Children don't belong next to fire rescue. You'll have some innocent kid riding a bicycle, someone going out this way fast, responding fast, and this kid gets killed. Don't do that.
Mr. Moderator, I've listened to the arguments. I think the Finance Committee is absolutely on target. There is no stated public purpose for this purchase at this point in time. Mrs. Keegan is correct. There's 15 acres or so right on the back of this building that we purchased a couple of years ago that we haven't developed. We have current projects that are being looked at as we speak, and I would like to defer this if possible, and in that spirit I'd like to move the question.
Thank you. I have a motion and a second to move the question. All in favor of moving the question signify with your gray card. Opposed? Motion to move the question passes. So now we'll move on to the motion. All in favor of the motion signify with your gray card. One. All opposed. Raise your gray card. Thank you. Abstentions. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight abstentions. So we have 1-4, eight abstentions, and 426 against. Motion fails. Article 16. Motion. Move that the town will vote to transfer and repurpose the following fund balances from highway garage insulation $3,500 to highway garage exterior window replacement $3,500. I have a motion. I have a second. I have a motion and a second. Any questions on the motion? I don't think we have a question. It's pretty straightforward. We have one.
I'm sorry. Andy Morris, 45 Roosevelt Street. The MassSafe program will give towns and individuals up to $2,000 a year of free insulation. Has anyone looked into that?
We want to.
Well, you guys should look into it.
All right, hold on.
Yeah, so we do actually participate in a number of energy programs, but this is a simple housekeeping article. We're just transferring the balance from an unused article over to a new purpose. So there's no impact on taxes, and it's just a housekeeping issue.
All in favor of the motion, signify with your gray card. Opposed? Abstentions, one opposed, article passes, 434 to 1.